Living in a city where crime, sex, and drugs prevailed, she was unsure of just how she would rise above the poverty-stricken streets and make a better life in what we call the ghetto.
The girl, better known as Lakisha Norman Davis, was born on January 24, 1979, at Howard University Hospital in Washington, D.C. She was born to Carolyn Davis and Rudolph Norman, though she lived in a single-parent home where her father was her sole provider. She received the type of love and nurturing a child would get from a two-parent home.
As she was growing up, Lakisha, also known as Smiley by her friends, faced many hardships and obstacles, all of which has helped her to grow into the strong woman that she is today. This is the quote she uses when she talks about her trials and tribulations. "My name is Smiley because I am gifted enough to smile through my adversity."
The lessons of life taught to her by her father have greatly prepared her for a successful existence in today's society.
Keisha, which in Swahili means favor, and is another name others know her by, went to Scott Montgomery Elementary and Shaw Junior High School. From there, she went to Cardoza Senior High School, where she received her diploma in 1997. Nevertheless, Lakisha did not stop at the high school level. She attended Southeastern University, Strayer University, and after making a decision about her career goals, she enrolled at Prince George's Community College, where she is studying child psychology.
In addition to Lakisha's studies, she is also involved in giving back to her community. She is a D.C. rape crisis activist and a survivor of this horrible crime. She writes, reads, and performs poetry at the historical Bohemian Caverns located at 11th and U Streets Northwest, a place where the late Duke Ellington, Louis Armstrong, and Ella Fitzgerald came after their Howard Theater shows to relax. Lakisha is a community activist for domestic violence and sexual abuse. Her passion for her people is remarkable. One of her famous quotes that she got from her dad is that nobody can help us from us but us, which means in the black community, we know each other's struggles. Therefore, we should be able to help each other through them.
And I'm worried about what I'm going to be when I grow up because I don't know. I want to be a singer. I want to own my own business. I just want to be a lot of things.
And are there people telling you that you can do that if you want to?
Yeah.
Who?
My father.
What does he say?
If you want to be something, you can be it if you want to.
What you know about that? What you know about me? Do you really know, Smiley? Pick up my book. Hey, don't think it's a hoax. I really want you to get to know me. See, we all need to understand each other. That's why I'm giving myself to you. See, this book is more than just entertainment. It's about letting you know that we have all been slaves. Slaves to the mental state of reality, which is false. Whoa.
What kinds of things are happening in the alley, do you know?
Drugs. That's all I know.
Do you hear things?
Yeah, I heard someone fighting. I heard someone fighting in the alley about 5 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning. They was fighting. This man was beating up this lady right there in the alley. But I ain't see it. I heard it.
See, what you know about living in a house with no water?
Only time I run through the alley to come back here is my
Pick
father
up my
in the
book
kitchen.
And flip the pages and That's get to know thing. The different stages of my life.
Thank you. There's a woman in Somalia scraping for pearls on the roadside. There's a force stronger than nature keeps her will alive. This is how she's dying. She's dying to survive. I don't know what she's made of. I would like to be that brave. She cries to the heaven above. There's a stone in my heart. She lives a life she didn't choose. It hurts like brand new shoes. Hurts like brand new. There is a woman in Somalia. The sun gives her no mercy. The same sky we lay under burns her to the bone. Long as afternoon shadows, it's gonna take her to get home. Each grain carefully wrapped up, pearls for her little girl.
Yourself, Suzanne.
Hi, I'm Suzanne Stachelitis. I'm a graduate student at the University of Maryland.
Tell us a little bit about the house.
It was built in 1746 by Christopher Lowndes, who was a tobacco merchant,
mm-hmm.
I believe, for the area. And it's been here for a long time.
Okay. All right. So we can take a tour now, right?
Sure.
Okay. Come on. We have just entered the back of the Boswick's house. This house was built in 1746 by the hands of slaves. I was told that each brick of this house was built one by one by the slaves, and then they put the house together. There was a historian in this room, and she told me that the slaves spent most of their time in this particular room because they had to keep up with the food and the children, and if they had meetings, they would serve tea. So this room is one of the main rooms in the master's house that the slaves were able to come on a regular basis. These same steps are the steps that belong to the slave master whose property was us, black people.
You call me.
Congratulations, Keisha.
No, she's
a cool
advantage.
Hey, mommy. Look, you got that. Hey, mom.
Trying to sit up.
Hey, mommy. Look at you got
the
that.
Breaking generational curses.
Ain't that right, mommy?
Okay, take three. Same thing.
I would like to introduce Serenity Keyshawn Johnson Davis.
Hello. Hello, world. Hello.
And she waved.
Hi. Say, I'm only 2 months and 3 days old. Yes, I am.
First question is, we want to welcome you. This is David Henry Small. We want to welcome you and thank you for being a part of this great project. And to start off, give the world a little bit of your background. Who are you?
Well, my name is David Henry Small, Jr. I was born in D.C. General Hospital. I graduated from Crossland High School in Temple Hills, Maryland, somewhere up in there. I was raised most of the time in Washington, D.C. Moved to Maryland when I was like 12, 13, somewhere up in there. My upbringing was pretty hard, but I got out. And I went to the Army, served 8 years, and got out, and now, here I am today.
Fantastic. Now, what inspired you to join the military, to join the Army?
Well, I wanted to make a difference, and I also wanted to get out of this trap in the metropolitan area. I wanted a new beginning, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah. So, you went to, So you went to Iraq twice. How do you feel about that now?
Well, I'm honored to defend my country and to have experienced what I've experienced and still came back with all my limbs and body parts and things of that nature. I'm blessed. I'm truly blessed.
So you're a veteran now. How do you feel about that title?
Well, me being a veteran, it comes with the title of defending your country. So I'm honored to be part of the veteran title.
There you go. So now, let's come to Lakisha. How did you meet Lakisha?
I met Lakisha at my cousin's wedding. She was very, very, well, she was a thought that I could never forget. The moment I saw her, she was reading this scripture for their union. And that's the first time I basically recognized her, and I knew. I was like, wow, she is something.
What was your impression of her?
She was amazing. She was amazing, and she was a child of God. That's what made her amazing, her mind and her being a child of God.
So when did you realize that you wanted to make her your wife?
I realized this last year, September time. I was like, wow, this woman has never changed. She is the real deal. She is what I can say that I will, I can basically say she's my Proverbs 31.
Okay.
She's my virtuous woman.
That's deep.
And she's the epitome of that in my eyes.
Now, do you think Lakisha is too liberated or super ambitious?
Yes. But that's a good thing. And
right answer.
I mean, I don't like a woman that is not liberated or don't know what they want or is just pretty much closed in. I like a woman that is very liberated.
That's good. Well, thank you so much for this interview. Looking forward to great things and keep it positive.
Yes.
And God first.
Always.
As you know.
Always.
Thank you.
All right, you're welcome.
Hello. Today I have with me McYon Brown. McYon is like my big sister that I've never had. We met, oh my goodness, I want to say about 12 years ago. This is 2014, and I believe I was about, I'm not going to tell my age, but we'll just keep it right there. So I'll let McYon tell you all how we met.
Well, I met Keisha from a good friend of mine. She's actually, her children are related to Keisha. They're Keisha's cousins. And at the time, Keisha was selling this weight loss product, and I was definitely interested in it. So that's how we actually met. I was buying product from her. And then with that door opening, it just turned into a friendship that has lasted so long. And I remember when I first met her, we had actually lived close to each other. I had lived down 450. And so I was catching the bus at this time going to work. And one day, lo and behold, I see Keisha get on the bus. And she's getting on the bus, and she this Bible-toting sister. And I just admired her. I'll say it was her energy and her glow. It was just something about her that it just attracted me to. And I was like, wow. So I got to talking to her and everything. And then in my own walk, I was in this place where I was searching for a church home and everything, you know, just trying to get myself together. And I used to ride down 450, and I would always see this. At this time, I would see this tent in the parking lot of Capitol Plaza. I didn't know what it was, but I heard that it was a church having like revival services there. And lo and behold, Keisha was a member of that church. And she invited me out one Wednesday night. She was like, you know, you got to come to my church. And I'm like, oh God, is this the answer that I needed? And so I went to church that Wednesday night, and the rest of it is history. I mean, it's like when this woman walked into my life, she came with so much more than just a weight loss product. I mean, it was just so much more. She brought a friendship to my life that I have never experienced before. I was one of those women who didn't believe that you can actually have a real good relationship with another woman. You know, I was used to all the cattiness and the talking behind each other's back, and you had to have on a certain label to be accepted among a certain group of people. And I used to roll with those group of people, but I was never happy. In the setting, I always knew that I wanted more from a relationship with a woman. And Keisha, she came into my life, and she proved to me that you can really have that relationship. And even with the other women that she bring around, it's like I trust her so much with who I am that when she brings another woman into the environment, I already know that this woman has already been pre-screened. She's on our page. She's ready to experience life in a different way than what she's used to. So I'm just honored to even know a person like Keisha. I have never met no one like her before in my life.
Same here. And what I want everyone to know is that McGyan is the president and the founder of the Lakisha Brown Foundation. And this foundation came about because McGyan lost her daughter at the age of 18 to domestic violence and gunfire. Not only that, she lost her niece to gunfire and domestic violence as well. She has a shirt on it, their picture on it. If she would turn around for the camera, if you could zoom in on that. This is her daughter, Keisha, and this is her daughter, Selena. Mm-hmm. So, her niece, I'm sorry. So, she lost both of them. So, I'm a part of the domestic violence organization, and I have just been promoted to vice president of the Lakisha Brown Foundation. Yes. So, in this organization, what we do is we put on events for the community. We try to educate people about domestic violence because myself and McYoung are survivors of domestic violence as well. So what we do talent shows, we do Thanksgiving drive baskets, toy drives. We do whatever we can to try to help the next young lady or young man that is being abused or murdered. You know, we want to make a change. No one else should have to lose their child, you know, to domestic violence. So we're out in the community and we're just trying to do what we can to help God's people, because at the end of the day, it's really not about us. Yes. It's about His people. So we're striving forward and we're making moves, and I'm blessed to have this beautiful young lady in my presence today, and I thank you so much. Now we come to the part in chapter 5. Dealing with relationships in the family. Here we have Kervin and little Kevin. They are both my cousins. They are the children of my cousin Kevin, and everybody knows Liz, that's her brother. Kervin and Kevin, like, were the loves of my life. They still are. Like, as soon as they came out of their mother, I was like, whoo, like, show me how to change them and this and that. Like, I was just so happy to have other kids in a house with me, because I was the kid. Like, I was the youngest cousin out of everybody. So I want to ask Kevin and Kervin some questions about their big cousin, Keisha. All right, we'll start with you, Kevin. Since you have been born, since you've been on this earth, can you honestly say, honestly, not because I'm your cousin, but say that I genuinely tried my best to show you love and teach you the right way. Like, I'm not perfect, you know, and now you grown, you gonna do you. But honestly, from the day you hit this earth until today, can you honestly say that? And how do you feel about me?
Yeah, I can say that you've been there for me. Because I think you and probably Marie, my stepmother that passed away, y'all are the only people that I can really talk to about what's going on with my mom, things like that. And you really understood where we were coming from. And when we was young, you used to take me with you all the time.
I picked the candle, the unlit candle, because a lot of stuff going on in my life, I kept in the dark. And I ain't never, like, reach out to nobody. And I think that's why I got a lot of anger built up inside of me. Say this candle, this lit candle, remind me of Keisha. Because when I brought it to her, she turned my doctor light. So.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
I love my
cousin. Oh my God! I love you too! No, no! Break his neck! Oh, I love you!
Don't get me hype up in here. I'm trying to tell you. Woo! People don't know why I'm so strong. They don't know what I've been through. Yes. Why you?
I would like to first give honor and thanks to God for giving me the ability and the strength to complete this project. I never thought that I could ever complete this project because there was a lot of adversity going on in my life. So I thank you, Father, for loving me unconditionally. It has taken a lot of energy and strength out of me, but I am a winner and I will succeed. And I am so happy that God has given me this special gift to put my life in a book for others to read. And also this documentary that wouldn't have been done if he had not brought Michael Thomas into my life, the producer of this great project. I'd like to thank my dad. Like, he is a true soldier. He raised me all by himself. And if it wasn't for his strength and his endurance, I wouldn't be here today. I would also like to thank the women in my life that helped me to become a young lady. I would like to thank Linda Jones Burns, my godmother since I was 7 years old, and her husband, Williton Burns. I would like to thank Edna Davis, my best friend's mother. She's always been a mother to me. I would like to thank Marissa Johnson, who was my supervisor for 7 years, and she retired, and she's still a mom to me after being retired for 5 years now. I would like to thank Dina Johnson Blocker for giving me the strength to push past my inner feelings towards a lot of different things in my life, helping me to succeed and, you know, keep on moving. I would like to thank Elizabeth Norman, who is my cousin, but she's always been like a mom to me. And I thank you for always being there for me. And I thank you, whoever's watching this documentary, for taking the time to get to know Lakisha Norman Davis, better known as Smiley, to my fans in the poetry room. So I thank you. Good night.